Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you my completed version of my Stirling Cider Cooler, which is used to cool the two Titan V's from Nvidia. And this is the casing I'm using, which matches the profile of the Stirling Cider Cooler. And what I'm going to show you for start, the power consumption at the current moment, which is 346.48 watts, or around 1/3 kilowatt, close to 1/3 kilowatts an hour. And as you can see, I'm using a water cooling solution for the Nvidia Titan V, and I got this what do you call it, hint to assemble this water cooling solution from Gamer Nexus. He was using a terminal grizzly compound from Chironon, and I'm using a Fuji Poly Ultra Extreme version, and also the thermal tape from Fuji Poly. The most important part you need to cool is the memory modules, which I'll show why you need to replace the stock thermal tapes, which is just a white tape. It's not suitable for overclocking purposes. And before I move on to the computer for display, I need to tell you some hints. Before placing the main board and the power supply into this casing, I had to monitor this unit for a few weeks before I can fully assemble, to ensure there's no leakage, because leakage of waters will be highly dangerous with electricity. Although I'm using a distilled water with a silver rod inside there, which was purchased many years ago. This is to prevent any formation of algae or any decoloration in the water over a long period of time. As you can see, my unit over here, I'm using a V-shaped a G14, a quarter inch, a V. I can't show what's the exact name. It's just a triple, double output, and one of it is going to the exit in case I need to remove the water for upgrade purpose or for maintenance purpose. And what I need to tell before you even assemble a water cool unit, you need to ensure the water is heat it up first while it's running, then close the cap. In this way, the pressure will not be too high. You can feel it by touching the tube. So do ensure the water is heated up around 50 plus degrees for my case. Of course, in my case it's only 46.3. After installing the fan over here, which reduced the temperature by around 3 degrees Celsius. If not, I mounted this a splitter for the fan, Arctic cooler fan. This is what I'm using. F12 silent Arctic cooler. See, hardly any sound. I'm using 7 of this fan for this system. This one I placed here, which need to be replaced because the temperature is around 37.8 degrees Celsius, and my room over here is typically 30 degrees Celsius. any time of the year. So the main highlight of this build is of course the Stirling Cerebro Cooler, apart from the Titan Beast. I'm also using the Thermo Coupon from this Thermo Grizzly this time to for better heat transfer. As you can see, the temperature of the water tank. It's only 34.6 degrees Celsius. I'm gonna show you the what I'm using, the settings, the, as you can see, the memory. I have overclocked to 120 megahertz, so this is what giving me the edge. So by Titan V's getting around 450 per day give or take at this current moment. This is the high end. Let's look at the low end, because there's still traffic card running in series, right? So the low end is 450. The water is going into this one, followed by this Titan V over here. Of course, if I'm using it for Ethereum, it's same thing as well, about 156 mega hash per second based on this memory clock offset of 120 megahertz. I can't go any higher. If I go any higher, I'm unstable. So this is the most stable I can get. And the power target is intentionally set at 55. Which I find reduced the power consumption about 30 watts without degrading the performance noticeably. So there you have it. This is the world first completed PC or server, if you want to call that. And what I emphasize, why I proceed with this build, is because I'm living in a small apartment. If my graphic cards or if my server is located in a barn or anything, I wouldn't be bothered. But since this server will be placed beside me as I sleep, so I need to emphasize on noise, which is the current moment, and also the temperature. The temperature from the output of this fan is merely 33.9. See, very negligible, slightly above my room temperature. And also, the most important thing I emphasize on is noise and also power consumption. So after this, I'm going to redesign the circuit again. Currently, the circuit, the original one, is designed for 500 Hz. I'm going to maintain at 500 Hz sine wave from the H bridge, but the sampling rate will be increased. From the current one is about 7.8 kilohertz, to in order to get the sine wave, the pure sine wave for this Stirling Cerebro Cooler 12 volts 500 hertz. So that's it. This is technically completed. Left only the cover and the circuit to enhance, to reduce the high harmonic noise coming from this unit. And for the remote, I'm using a spider
which was bought second hand from the eBay for $100+. That's about it.